Pearl of Wisdom by Newness of Life Ministries www.trcb.me/noel. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking fine pearls, and upon finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had, and bought it. Matthew 13:45-46. At truth at any cost and don't sell it at any price. I can remember looking at my grandfather's hands. The inside of them were rough like leather. His hands were very large and strong. Indeed, there was no animal, horse, bull or boar that he could not handle. His hands, strong arms and body were the result of years of back-breaking labor on his farm. He rarely took a vacation, only a day off once and a while, and he traveled little, except that it was farm-related or an occasional visit to relatives. He built a two-room schoolhouse for his children and hired a teacher, because he really valued education. He saw education as the way a person could get ahead using his brain. He used to say, "Nay day I will no longer be strong enough to work the farm, even with labor to aid me. You need to get an education so that you will be able to work well into your years, using your brain rather than your back." Your article could be in this broadcast. Visit trcb.com to find out how. The mantra for our family became, "At an education, no one can ever take it from you." Proverbs 23 teaches us today. Proverbs 23:23-23, "Buy truth, and do not sell it, get wisdom and instruction and understanding." Psalm 82:5-85, "They do not know nor do they understand. They walk about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are shaken." 6. "I said, you are gods, and all of you are sons of the Most High." 7. "Nevertheless you will die like men, and fall like any one of the princes." 8. "Arise, O God, judge the earth. For it is thou who dost possess all the nations." Today's question: do you value education? When you talk with people about education today, they will usually say education is important to get a good job. Even those who are more thoughtful will say something like, "Want to be a lawyer because they make lots of money." The focus is on money and materialism rather than wisdom and instruction. That simply is not all my grandfather wanted. He valued wisdom and truth. A truth that was based on his study of the Bible. His conversation was full of interesting stories, concepts that he learned from God as he contemplated scriptures working alone in the fields, but also from observation of others, where he learned that it is far more valuable to be honest in dealings with your fellow men and how can you do business with one who lies. His thinking was that if you applied the wisdom of the Bible to learning all that you could about a particular area of education, you could do great things. Can you imagine what kind of child Jesus was? A child who loved and respected his parents, who learned carpentry from his earthly father, Joseph. On one of his family's visits to Jerusalem, his parents lost Jesus. They were looking all over for him, and it came about that after 3 days they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, both listening to them, and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. Luke 2:46-47. You see, Jesus did not learn either carpentry or the scriptures simply to get a good job, but his interest was in higher values than these. The value of knowing God, living by his principles and working in obedience to him in service to others. And he went down with them, and came to Nazareth. And he continued in subjection to them. And his mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus kept increasing in wisdom and stature, and in favor with God and men. Luke 2:51-52. Dear God, raise our sights on the value of education. That truth, wisdom, instruction and understanding are of great value to go beyond getting a job, but living a life of quality and meaning both now and forever. Amen. Visit trcb.com for more great articles like this now. Music by Kevin MacLeod.